Welcome back to the Crooked Spine Show. Today's talk is about your shoulders. How do we keep them loose, strong, and pain-free? With everyone working from home right now, being a student or being an actual business person, at that point I'm getting a lot of shoulder problems in my office with the shoulder rotated forward, causing shoulder pain, upper back pain, and neck pain, and headaches. So this is my previous talk. This is a replay from 2019. We talk about the cause of shoulder injuries, the cause of shoulder problems, also long-term effects of shoulder issues. Also, how do we start recovery? What motions do we have to increase to start recovery? Along with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 stretches and exercises to keep your shoulders loose and strong. We'll walk through in the actual talk itself. The talk is a little bit weird today. The sound broke off halfway through, so I actually did a play-by-play for the second half. So I did shorten the talk, but it'll give you play-by-play for that. So go to the video if you want to watch the actual talk. If not, in the show notes, I'm going to have links to the actual exercise you can start doing to stretch and strengthen your shoulders. Enjoy the talk, my friends. Again, the highlights has the highlights again of the exercises. Go there. Now enjoy the talk, and I'll wrap it up afterwards. I did a talk last Friday, and off topic, to graduate students who want to go to med school, become medical doctors, somewhere in healthcare, at a graduate level, or even a research scientist too. And a lot with them was they didn't understand what seniors need from their doctors. They didn't know. You know, and a lot of it is what I was talking to them, took them all to figure out, is seniors want to maintain their independence.
Yes.
I think. That's what I've been told by you guys. So a lot of it is how do you get them to get healthy enough to get there? And spend time with them when you see them to listen to their problem. I did talk last week, last Tuesday morning, down at Brookdale in Ontario. A lot of it was I asked them, what do you guys want from your doctors? We also talked about technology and how it works with patients. A lot of just, doctor, listen to me. I have 5 things I want to go through. I want him to sit there and listen until I'm done. Not be on his computer putting stuff in and not looking at me in the eye as I'm trying to talk to him and explain what I'm going through. Because people talk through their voice, through their expressions, through their mannerisms, through how they look in their eyes, so their posture too. You have to see all of that as a doctor, I think, to understand what they're going through.
But also, doctor, some doctors are limited to time they can spend with a patient. They have so many backed up that I was told once, you know, your 15 minutes are up and I only got 2 questions answered. I couldn't, you know.
Well, in my question to that question is, or that statement is there a way to rationalize not spending time with people, or is it an excuse? Then don't book so many people. Sorry. Sorry you have to have a Jaguar, live on top of the hill, and have a boat and expensive vacation planned. And have a high overhead. When you have those expenses in your head as implied, I have to see 100 people a day just to meet my overhead every month. No. And the people I met last week, too, again, a couple of them are saying, my doctor spends time with me and he drives a used car, like myself. So a lot of it is you can minimize your budget to accommodate spending time with patients. Definitely give them the care that they want. Okay. When I have patients come in my office for shoulder pain, for example, okay, going back to our topic today, a lot of it is not the pain itself, but how it limits their lifestyle, their activity level, ability to sleep, ability to not be anxious, ability to relax, ability to stay strong. So my job is to deal with the back end with shoulder pain, not just the front end of where it's coming from. When I interview a patient who has shoulder pain, if it's chronic, more long-term, what was the initial cause? I had someone come in last week, car accident 2 years ago. It's finally gotten so bad, now it affects your ability to sleep, stand, even hold their arm up. This week, another car accident case, coincidentally, she had a total brachioplex injury where she hurt her neck from the accident. Now it shut down the nerve in her arm about a year ago. Now she can't lift her arm up.
I think there's a lot of asymmetry where it's either the right arm and leg or the left. And at least half of it is due to computers where you're leaning over like this.
It can be. Exactly, more long term.
And the other half is driving. In this country, it's the right thing. And the England, it's the other side.
So shoulder pain can come from bad posture over a long period of time. Mm-hmm. And what happens when you have that, your body, like you had mentioned, is what happens is your body will rotate forward, hunch forward. It makes the neck and shoulders combination, neck and shoulder combination, to roll forward. Now the shoulder comes forward.
Yeah.
Now the shoulder joint that's meant to stay here rotates forward. Now you push the joint out of line. So every time you've got to come up or over, it doesn't want to do that. So it wants to lock. If a joint locks over time, the muscles get weaker and weaker and weaker and tighter and cause more pain with even minimal motion. If you have pain in your shoulder, what is connected to your neck? Those neck connect to your nerves, to your head and your brain, causing where you can't sleep because your body's under stress and tension the whole time. That pain goes to the whole body, affecting the whole lifestyle, whole quality of life. Some people come to my office, they have pain medications for a long period of time for shoulder pain, neck pain. They've never fixed the problem of causing more motion, and over time getting it stronger, even if it's going to be sore, so at that point things heal properly. I have people all the time go through that. They come in, they're like this. My shoulder's killing me. Depressed, anxious, quiet. Very quiet. My job, okay, let's figure out what happened. You've had this 2 years now. What have you done so far? Medications, maybe some physical therapy, and that's it. Doc told me to rest and go away. It's not going away. Now it's locked up. Well, now we have to loosen things up. I have to take an x-ray. X-ray most of the time is fine on the shoulder because the nerves now from the neck and shoulder cuff work together to keep that shoulder guarded and tight and painful. So once I do that, I go, okay, we're going to treat the neck and shoulder together, but I want you to start moving. And they give me this look like I'm crazy. Moving? My doctor told me 10 times not to move my arm if it hurts. 10 times. I go, well, I'm not that type of doctor. I want you to get better. I want to get better, right? Yes. Has not moving worked for you? No. Let's try something different. Now we know nothing's torn or broken inside. We can move things. It's not going to make it worse. That point, we start moving it very, very slowly. What I mean by moving, okay, is I take this shoulder, okay, and the shoulder meaning for me are a few things. Let me move closer to you guys so you can see me. Here is the shoulder is that shoulder joint, but also AC joint, if you want to call it that specifically. Shoulder joint's inside here. But that AC joint controls your ability to raise your arm up, bring your arm rotated backwards, rotate in a little bit, but mostly backwards and up. Okay? The problem is if our body's stuck like this, that shoulder AC joint now affects this muscle up to the neck, causing neck tightness and stiffness, causing even upper back, push my arm up on that shoulder blade too. So that whole triangle here, here, here is all affected. Our body stays tight and sore and weak because now it can't raise your arm. So my job is, how do I fix that? To start with, this is too sensitive. I'm not going to be able to touch that yet. What I'm going to do is focus on the areas around that are not as sensitive, such as the neck and upper back, to look at that. I'm doing upper trap stretch. This one here, bring your hand, opposite hand, behind your ear, and pull and turn your head toward that same shoulder. Now, bring your head toward your body. Get that neck to stretch. It's called the upper trap stretch. That being upper trap muscle, the one right here, from the neck to your shoulder, get that to move and stretch. Enough tension to where you feel tightness, maybe tiny bit of soreness, but no pain when you pull down that way. Okay? When you do that, hold that about 30 seconds at a time. And if it feels, if it depends on the injury, the neck injury also made you just do one side. The shoulder injury only want to do both sides, to loosen up both sides of that neck. Okay, part of my video is what I do too, is send you the actual video of this stretch in our main video and the post itself so you actually see that stretch specifically.
Could
yes.
That also be used for a neck?
Exactly, combination of neck and shoulder. So again, if that upper trap muscle attaches right here at the AC joint, along the neck and the upper back, that moves up the neck and upper and shoulder and upper back together. It's all one complex of muscles. So one's been affected for a long time, it'll all be affected together.
Well, at LA Fitness, mm-hmm. on Tuesday and Thursday at 11, those things reminded me of a whole hour of stuff like this.
Perfect.
It's all stretching and I forget what they call it.
Yoga?
No, it's not yoga. It's
Pilates.
There you go. But a lot of it is, can you hold the stretch long enough to be effective? When you're stretching muscles, right? I may do this to stretch a muscle. But I want to hold a ligament stretch to help my neck and shoulder. So that when the ligament and the tendon of the muscle helps relax it even more.
About 15 seconds.
I would about 30 seconds. I'm more of a longer patient person. 30 seconds minimal and maybe a minute total. Okay? It's called the upper trap stretch again too. I'm going to send the video in the video notes. That's when you have some video for it that's called the upper trap stretch. And always want to do both sides to make both sides looser. All right? Any questions yet?
I had my surgery a couple of years ago, right?
I know.
These exercises.
Very good. Very good. Let's do one on the wall.
It's actually called
the stretching. Does it do anything, or is it just when you stretch your hands to touch, that's a good one.
I loosen things up also, too.
One side's harder than the other.
Yeah, it's going to be a little bit tighter on that side, too.
This thing at LA Fitness, they call it silver sneakers.
Yes, that's the one.
Silver sneakers.
It works. It works, though, right?
Yeah.
So I'm going to show you this one, too. This is called a T-stretch. You want to know why? Because I'm Dr. Tony, T, Dr. T, Mr. T. That's me. Okay. Let me make sure you get that. So we want to do this one. Now we want to do, if our shoulder's like this, right? It's turned in. We're hunching forward. That body can't go backwards. I want to unwind that shoulder to open things up. So I want to start by making that anterior shoulder muscle, along with what's underneath that's going to be called your pec minor muscle, to stretch. Okay? So I'm going to come across here, this way, and I'm going to put my arm across the wall, straight across from my shoulder. From here, if this feels comfortable, now turn your body away from that shoulder, away from the wall. Use this hand if you need to push for tension to get that muscle to stretch. That's the first stretch of this T-stretch exercise. Want to be my demonstrator, sir? Oh no. Painful.
Like this?
It's like that. Good. Okay? So now, and actually, watch me too. Watch me, right? Watch me. Look at me.
I'm not hearing too well.
Look at me. My hand, I'm going to put my hand here. So watch me first. Put my hand here. I'm going to come across. I'm going to push myself out. So come over here.
Yes.
Let's go over here. Watch, go that way.
I'm facing the wrong way.
Chuck, let me work with you here. Okay, let's go right over here. Okay. So watch me first. I'm here,
okay.
Hand here, and then push myself around to make my body over time look this way.
Twisting the feet.
Twisting your body, exactly. So bring your body this way. There. Is that, what's that sound?
It's starting to hurt all in here.
It's pain?
It's bearable.
Good. Switch sides. So this arm now here, this hand here, and now turn your body this way.
You hold 30 seconds also?
About 30 seconds to a minute, exactly.
Okay.
Good. How's that feel, Chuck? I'm okay with the feet, as long as the upper body's turning. That's the biggest. That's step one of the T-stretch. Man, it's going to take a while.
It reminds me of whether the pain is good somehow, or whether it's a message to stop doing what you're doing.
It's a good pain. It's a good pain. Next one, Chuck. Don't leave yet.
Go back.
So you're going to go from here, right? Here?
Yeah.
Now, this is number two. You're going to come up here, straight up, and push your armpit against the wall and lean into it to feel that shoulder stretch even more.
I feel it right here.
There you go. So it's pulling. So if it's not here, it's here, that whole muscle is tight. And that neck is a little tight too.
Right, that's where it's worst.
Yeah. All right, that feel okay?
Yeah. Switch sides. It's not great, but
switch sides.
Not hurting.
And then bring this arm down.
Okay.
All the way down.
I feel that in my shoulder.
Let's go higher up too. How's that?
Bearable.
Good, I like bearable. Bearable, we're looser and stronger. We get that whole shoulder loosen up here and help that neck loosen up too, along with the arm, the lats, latissimus dorsi, going from the shoulder to the ribs, along with the whole area in that spot too. But having that extra tension allows you to relax on the wall to make things want to stretch even more. So try that and see. I want to make sure you feel what I'm talking about.
It's gonna make you taller.
Oh no, the video sound just died during the middle of the shoot. We had done Facebook Live and it killed the video. So what I'm going to do is do a voiceover the rest of the video. Right now you're watching, I think it's Chuck and Miranda do the three shoulders T-stretch. Let's get right to that for one, two. I'm going to ad-lib it through. You're going to fast track. Instead of being about 27 minutes, I'm going to save you time, a lot of time, making about 6 minutes on a fast speed. All right, so hope you're entertained and entertained and educated by this. At that point, I'll see you afterwards. So here's Miranda finishing up the second part of the T-stretch. See how her arm's a little bit uneven? I'm working with her to see to make sure it gets that left side a little bit loose, a little bit stronger over time. At that point, she realizes to get that left side looser. This is the third part of the T-stretch. At that point, she's doing left and right, keeping that shoulder loose and strong. I'm going to put these show notes in the video. A little upset and frustrated because we have communication issues. That's about it. I'm showing her again the summary. We do first one here, lean our shoulder across, right? At that point, gets the outside shoulder stronger. At that point there, do the same thing. This is how you do it, Miranda. Come on now, follow along here. All right, so she's a little bit more time taken to get this thing done, but we're working with her. All right, so left side, right side. Her right side is a little bit looser than her left. As she realizes, we'll walk through that even more with someone else. This is called another stretch too. This is with Maria. Understand this is her stretch she gave me, how to stretch your shoulders backwards by doing this. That makes the shoulders come back. It's never back to stretch two more into extension. All right, so again, one more time. Same thing. Make sure I do it right. Good. Look at that. Man, I have some good flexibility in there. It's pretty awesome, I think, myself. All right, so next stretch to talk about, too, is going to be the towel stretch. Actually, I'm going to send this video to you all so you have this. It's how you wrap it up, wound it up, I think, and you pull up and down. When you're pulling down the towel, your upper arm is pulling, is getting stretched out the tricep and shoulder. When you pull up, stretches the back of the shoulder too and the front shoulder. So you're doing everything at the same time. This is about four or five stretches at one thing by doing the towel stretch, left or right side as you see. All right, so hopefully that entertains you too. Next one, I think, let's walk through it because I'm talking about something else, is how you stretch the shoulders backwards to make that hunched look posture, make that get added to make your back straighter and your shoulders stronger overall. Your shoulders wind in, so you want to make sure you wind it out. At that point, make that shoulder unwind like a piece of rope, all right? And I kiss my bicep, for example, there. I don't know why. All right, let's go through this real quick. We're talking about that. Again, the shoulder stretch. Get those other upper one, get that elbow above your shoulder. At that point, make that shoulder have full range of motion by passive stretching versus just pushing your shoulder across. The towel helps you passively stretch, causing more range of motion, more movement, and then eventually a stronger shoulder. See what else you have to say right here. Let's walk through this. He keeps talking. This talks forever. I don't really talk so much for. All right, next is your three shoulder exercise. When you want to do it against the wall, I'm off there first. We want this against the wall, I'll tuck your elbows in. When you tuck your elbows in, at that point allows your overall hands and body to be locked in to hold that upper back posture, the straight posture. We want to make sure we maintain that over our body can stay straight. All right, so we're going to come back against the wall again, I think. At that point, calm things down. This is a shrug move too. At that point, the shrug move allows your shoulders to get stronger. Let's go back to your three shoulders. Tuck the elbows in, bring the hands away, so at that point they're trying to hit the wall on both sides. Make sure you keep those elbows in. Gets the front shoulder to stretch, the back of your shoulder to strengthen. It called your posterior delt, the back of your shoulder, the whole time. All right, let's pause right here. So after you've done the external rotation of the shoulders with your elbows locked into the sides, now you want to bring your elbows horizontal with your shoulders and now bring your arms backwards. So you want to have your hands to touch the wall above your head or next to your head all the way up. This stretches the front shoulder even more and the back shoulder is strong. So you start adding weights like a water bottle, it'll actually feel more load, more pressure in the shoulder this way. So this is something we want to be careful with. When you bring your arms back, make sure you go as far back as you can. You want to make sure you go too far back. I do it every day, so I have full range of motion. You may only go back halfway. That's okay. Okay? You want to make sure that shoulder opens up all the way as you come backwards. Alright? So again, bottom then up. At that point, the last one you want to do is now being against the wall, instead of being against the wall completely, now what we want to do is keep our hips on the wall, bring our feet forward, and now hands and arms or body leaning forward. This allows you to use your upper shoulders and back to pinch the back of your neck. At that point, like that, exactly like that. At that point, get the arms to come up, lower horizontal to the overall body. All right? This gets the shoulders stronger over time as it gets looser first and then stronger for the last one, even reverse fly too. So in here I'm talking even more, keep going. We want to get our shoulders back, have that straight posture, right? So how do we reinforce that? That's the plan. So keep things going. Good talking about that too. Keeping that body and shoulders back. Keep that body open for one, two. Keep the hands open as much as you can. I think Chuck's saying something about something. Okay. We're going to do now of a how do we sit properly? I think Maria had asked a question. How do we sit properly? So we want to make sure our body is upright. At that point, our knees are behind us, and we lean back more. That's going to be the overall plan. Get back to exercise for the shoulder right here. We want to make sure our body stays straight. So when we walk, we want to make sure when we walk, keep our body up the whole time and the weight on our heels. As you can see, I'm leaning back on my heels more. My body's leaning back overall. Keep my back overall straight. All right. Next one here. Go back to the shoulders. One, two. How do we make that strong like we did before? Now we want to do an overhead shoulder press. Okay. When we do that, our shoulders should be parallel with our overall body. Come up next to our heads. That gets the shoulders stronger. Once you've done the other exercise, now we're going to go to this one to make our overall shoulders stronger in this last one here. All right, so modification I'm showing right now is the knuckles being pointed in. That allows the shoulders to pinch even more, causing more tension in the neck and shoulders. At that point, it can be good if it feels good. If it feels painful, hold off on it. What you usually want to do is bring the hands, the palms facing forward. This gets the palms facing out. Just touch your knuckles to cause more neck and shoulder pressure and cause more strength for your shoulders overall, keeping your body up the whole time. Again, posture is very important, how your overall body works. All right, now I'm talking about something else. Here we go. I don't know what it is. This is my wrap-up of all the exercises. Make sure when you do these exercises for the shoulder, especially, your posture has to be back. So I had a six-second posture video, one of the videos we started out with, one, two. Set your posture first, and then bring your shoulders back so your overall body can relax and heal. The exercise, again, you always start with stretching first. When that feels good, then you move the strengthening, but again, maintain that better position the whole time so your body stays back on your overall heels, all right? So make sure you do this when you're sitting, when you're standing, routine, 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 doing it every day along with the icing afterwards. Have a great day. Again, guys, right now, if you're a student or if you work from home, we're going to be at our computers for a long time before we get back to our office or back to our actual facility of being the school, right? So hope this helps you keep your shoulders strong, at that point even loose, so that point helps you avoid neck pain, shoulder pain, upper back pain. So you can stay relaxed and not get angry at your computer because you have to sit for so long. Right, so the show notes has the actual highlights and times of the actual exercise, or you can jump right to the link to the exercise. At that point, do these consistently over time, especially during the week when you're studying or working. Keep your body loose, strong, and relaxed so you don't get angry at your computer and you stay happy, my friends. Right, so again, the show notes has the actual podcast, has the actual video. You can watch either one, whatever way you learn. Stay loose, strong, my friends, and I'll see you next week.